How to package your coaching offer. What type of offers should you have? They're telling you to have more than one offer at different price points. And it makes sense, right? Today, I'm going to share with you what is the most important thing when it comes to packaging offers and how you should package your offers in your coaching business. Hey, I'm Karma Hunter, owner of KarmaDNA.com. I help coaches, freelancers, and online entrepreneurs just like you get clients consistently without social media burnout so that you can scale with evergreen systems and strategies. I post weekly content about online marketing, coaching, and entrepreneurship. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to receive the latest updates on my videos. Don't forget to check out the free trainings under the description of my videos. Today, I'm going to walk you through how you can package your offer to convert more high-ticket clients. Like we said earlier, having different price points makes sense, right? However, it really doesn't unless you have a real value ladder. What is a value ladder? A value ladder is a series of offers and different price points. However, it's only a value ladder if the value also differs in price points in a logical order. One of the biggest mistakes coaches make while they're packaging their offers or while they're creating their value ladder is only to look at the price. They try to give cheaper offers in order to accommodate more people in order to give more affordable options. However, when it comes to a value ladder, or even in any type of content, your main goal is to give the most value. So it's not about giving something cheaper. Don't think about just selling something or don't think about what to sell. And it's not about giving a more affordable option. It's all about the value. Think of it this way. So in your value ladder, as the price goes up, the value needs to go up. But that doesn't mean give them more stuff. Please don't give them more stuff. You know why? Because the more stuff you give, the more confused they will be. I know you want to give them the most, but trust me, when you just think about giving more stuff or more information, whatever it is, it doesn't do any good to your client. So don't give away the bank. At least not just yet. Don't confuse them. The reason why you are creating a value ladder is to graduate them to the next level. Think about it this way. Look at the value ladder just like a real ladder. Bottom is your free content. This free content is to create awareness, not just to give something for free or not just to give them, to throw some free information, but to create awareness so that you can attract the right target audience. Next step could be your tripwire or your lead magnet. This piece of content you're giving them should train and graduate them to the next level, which is your small offer. And your small offer is an introduction to either your medium or your high ticket offer. To give you an example, I'm going to give you behind the scenes to my value ladder and explain how it works. First, I have my free content, either evergreen or social media. Second is my lead magnet, my opt-in, free opt-in offer. Third, I have a tripwire offer, which is a very, very tiny offer, we should say. And then it goes to my medium offer, which leads to my flagship program, my high ticket offer. So I have 5 steps to my value ladder. Let's talk about why. With my free content, whether it's evergreen or social media, I'm teaching the very basic steps because I can't sell my flagship offer, my high ticket offer, to someone who doesn't know about a niche or a target audience or an opt-in page, what a conversion rate is, and the basic steps. So all my free evergreen content and my social media content is a step to my lead magnet, my freebie. My lead magnet is about writing a high converting opt-in page, which is the first step to creating a simple funnel. So if a lead signs up for this free offer, I know that they know what an opt-in page is, and they are building a simple sales funnel or a lead generation funnel. Otherwise, why would they get a free course talking about a high converting opt-in page, right? Which leads to my tripwire, my tiny small offer. Now that we know the lead is creating an opt-in page, this could only be for launch campaigns or launching a product or a service or a business. But at the end of the day, somehow they need some type of a campaign. So that lets me know that my launch planner, which is my small offer, my tiny offer, is perfect for them. Because I know that you are building a simple funnel. So it will definitely benefit you. That's exactly what a person who's going to have a launch campaign is going to need. Think about the difference. If I was to refer everyone to a launch planner, it may have attracted a different type of audience who were not going to have a launch campaign, which means that there's no process of elimination, which means that I don't know if we are a good fit with that lead or not. After the small offer, we can offer a medium or the high ticket offer. Now, if the lead gets my launch planner, now it's confirmed that they are going to have a launch. And I can offer them my medium offer, which is a course that will help them set up their evergreen content and evergreen systems so that they are now ready to scale. And I can offer my flagship program, which is my high ticket offer, to help them with one-on-one mentorship to scale their business. And when they sign up with me, they already have a small funnel, a small offer, and their evergreen content already in place. So at each step of the way, I am qualifying my leads for the next level. And when they're ready to sign up with me, they get the best value and best results. It's a win-win for both of us. So when you're working on packaging your offer or creating a value ladder, make sure to think about the content and the value you're going to give to them. Make sure to give them the right tools to graduate. Which one of these steps do you want to add to your value ladder? Let me know in the comments. As always, I hope you like this information and have a great day. See you next time.